Hey everyone, so in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install IntelliJ IDEA and also how to set it up for Spring Boot. So for this we need to download IntelliJ IDEA and as well configure Java, and then only we will be able to run our Spring Boot project. So I'll be showing you all these three in this video, so let's get started. So first thing, just go to Google and type download IntelliJ IDEA. You'll be getting the first link as jetbrains.com. Just click that, and in this website, first thing you'll be having the IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate Edition, which is a paid one. And if you want to go with the free one, just scroll down, and here we'll be having the IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition. This is for free, and you need to just click on download. So the download is getting started, and it is about 664 MB in size. So just be patient. So once the download is complete, just open the file. Yeah. Just click on yes, and you'll be getting the IntelliJ IDEA community setup. Just click on next, and this is the default location where this is going to get installed, which is in local disk C and program files. If you want to change the path, you can change it. I am fine with this. I will just click on next, and in this we need to check this IntelliJ IDEA shortcut. This is good. And update the path variable, this is also fine. Open as project folder, this is fine. And I am going to use this for .java purpose. I'm not going to do Gradle or any other thing extra. So just click on this one. If you want, you can just check on Gradle or Groovy depending upon your use case. Just click on next, and this is fine. Just click on install. So once the installation is complete, you'll be getting an option to restart your system. So if you want to restart it right now, you can just click on reboot and click on finish. I don't want to restart it now, so I'll just click on finish. So after it is installed, let me just go to search and type for IntelliJ. I'll be having this one over here. I'll just open it, and we need to click on do not import settings. Just click on OK, and we'll be getting the interface now. So now we are done with the installation of IntelliJ. Let's just go and download and install Java JDK. So just go to Google and type Java JDK download, and you'll be getting the first link as Java downloads. Just click that. It is from oracle.com, and here we will be having Java 20 and Java 17, and Java 20 is the latest version of Java, the latest JDK version. So you can just go here, scroll down, you'll be having it for different operating systems. We are going to download it for Windows. Just click on Windows, and here you will be having MSI installer. So just click on that. So it is about 158 MB in size, so just be patient till that. So once the download is complete, just click on open. You need to click on next, and you can just change the location if you want to. The default is fine for me, so I'll just click on next. So the installation will begin. That's it. So once the installation is complete, you will be getting this successfully installed message. Just click on close. So now we need to add our Java path to the environment variables, alright? So just go to the folder where you have installed Java. So by default, it's going to be C, Program Files, Java, JDK 20, and you'll be having this bin thing. So you need to copy the till bin folder, just Control C, just go to search and type environment. You'll be getting the edit the system environment variables option. Just click on open. And in this, you'll be having here environment variables. Click that, and under system variables, just click on path, edit. You need to click on new, and you need to just paste this. All right, you need to have till bin folder, and just click on OK everywhere. Now just open your command prompt. Just zoom it. So we need to run the command java hyphen hyphen version and hit enter. So here you can see that I'm getting Java 20, which is the latest version of Java that we have installed right now. So you'll be getting this message if you have done the installation process in a perfect way. So in case if you aren't getting this, you must have made a mistake in the path. Go to your browser and search for Spring Initializer. You'll be getting the first link, start.spring.io. Just select that. And this is going to contain our entire Spring Boot project. And we are going to configure the necessary dependencies and as well the Java version over here. So first thing, project is going to be Gradle and Groovy. If you want Maven, you can choose that, but I am comfortable with Gradle. And next one is going to be language. I will choose Java and I will leave it with a default Spring Boot version. And here we need to change the name of our project. Okay, we will be having this project metadata, and I will just name this as Spring One, and you can just remove everything to Spring One, and I'm fine with the packaging jar and the Java version. And next most important thing is the dependencies. So by default, we'll be using the Spring Web dependency, which is used for creating those endpoints, the post, put, delete, and fetch operations. So we'll be using the Spring Web dependency. And depending upon whether you are using MySQL or MongoDB database, we'll be using the JPA or that particular driver. So for example, for MySQL, we are having the MySQL driver, and for MongoDB, we'll be having the MongoDB driver. So this is optional. If you want, you can just install this. So once you're done selecting the necessary dependencies, you can just click on generate. So it will be getting downloaded as a zip file. So just go to your downloads and you need to just extract this. Extract files, so I'll just click on OK. Yeah, so this is extracted, and inside this we will be having all our Java files over here. So we're having the Java thing, right? So now we are good here. So now let's just go and open our IntelliJ IDEA. So after opening IntelliJ IDEA, you'll be getting an interface like this. We need to just click on open, and now you need to select the folder where you have extracted our zip file. So in my case, it is present under downloads. So I would recommend you to cut this particular extracted file and paste it in some other directory rather than having it in downloads. So once you have located that particular project, just expand this, select the folder that is inside the main folder. So for example, I'm having here two Spring One, which one is the parent and another one is the child folder. So I would recommend you to select the child folder. All right, just select this and click on OK. Just click on trust project. It will take some time for the Gradle to load. So it says Gradle downloading Gradle. So just be patient till then. So once you don't have any Gradle processing over here, what you need to do is just expand this source folder, expand main, expand Java, and here you'll be having this Spring application one file. Just double click it, and by default you'll be having this run icon over here. Just click that, and you need to just click on run Spring Boot application main. So at the top you'll be having this Spring One application. Just click that and just click on this edit configurations, and here you can see if you don't have here Java module over here, if you just click this, it will be getting automatically configured. If it doesn't automatically detect that, you need to just click on this and specify this, but in most of the cases it will get automatically configured. So now we are good, and if I just now go here, here you can see my Spring Boot application has started. It says Tomcat started on port 8080, which means that we have successfully set up our Spring application with IntelliJ as well as Java. So I hope you'd have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in Spring Boot, MySQL, MongoDB, CRUD operations. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.